Have you ever woke up one day looking like shit and you're like,
they ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't.
And then you realize you have responsibilities. You need to go out to meet people. And you don't want to do that because you have all these
under eye dark circles, swollen eyes, and oily face. Maybe you stayed up till 5 doing that assignment. Maybe you stayed up till 5 playing that video game that you like. So you just woke up really tired with your face looking like shit. But that's okay, I am here to save you.
Today I'm gonna teach you guys how to do this easy makeup that you can wear every day to look your best. The thing is, I don't really wear makeup every day, but this is what I would do if I want to go out on a date. Just kidding, nobody asked me out.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't.
Or if you want to go to school, go to work, where you don't want to wear too much makeup but still want to look more awake and more put together, you know what I mean? And this makeup look is perfect because it enhances your natural beauty without being so dramatic and changing your entire face, making you look like a different person.
So if you want to achieve this look, just keep watching. Okay, so firstly, you're gonna take a moisturizer to prime your face. The one that I like using now is the Clinique, what's it called? Dramatically Different Moisturizer Gel.
I'm not a beauty blogger. I used to be really bad at doing makeup, but then I watched a lot of makeup tutorials on YouTube and found out what really suits me, and it makes me look better. So if you're new to makeup, you should always try to find some looks that work for you. Otherwise, it just doesn't really work with your face, I guess.
So after we put on the moisturizer, we're gonna put on the primer. The primer that I use, it's a product from Japan. I will link all the products down below in the description box. Just take about this much, and then I'm gonna put it on my face. Ah!
You have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just.
So finally, we're getting into the makeup part of this tutorial.
As you can see, I don't really have a lot of acne problems, so I don't want to put a foundation on because it makes my face look cakey and just doesn't look good. It makes me look like I'm wearing a lot of makeup. So I'm just going to use a concealer, but if you like it, you could use a foundation underneath the concealer, but you know, that's your choice.
It's the Urban Decay Naked Skin Weightless Complete Coverage Concealer in the shade Light and Neutral. So I'm just gonna put it underneath my eyes to cover up this dark circles, and a little bit on the bridge of my nose to make it look taller. And then I use it to cover some acne scars that I have. Okay, and then I'm gonna use a damp beauty blender from Real Techniques. Or you can use any sponge that you like and just blend out the concealer that we just put on. Excuse me. After the concealer is blended out, I'm gonna take a powder foundation to set my face. You can use any powder you like, but since I didn't put on any foundation, I'm just gonna use this one. It's very lightweight. It's the Bare Minerals Bare Pro Powder Foundation. Yeah, in the shade. Who cares?
I'm just gonna put it underneath my eyes to set the concealer that I just put on. Just put it on everywhere that I put concealer. Also, on the other parts of my face.
So now my skin looks more flawless. Just kidding. But it doesn't really look like I'm wearing makeup, you know, which is what we want. Okay, so now that we're done with the base makeup, we're gonna contour because my face is big. You know what? I'm done with this accent. I'm gonna use my normal accent now.
I sound like an alien.
Okay, so I'm gonna take this Wet n Wild contour brush and I'm gonna use the e.l.f. contour palette to contour my face.
Firstly, take a lighter shade. And put it under my cheekbones. Oh, why do I keep switching accents? To make my cheeks look smaller. And on my jaw lines to make my face look smaller, even though it doesn't really work. And also on my hairline because I have a really big forehead that I want to make it look smaller as well.
And then I'm gonna take this darker shade to kind of make the contour more dramatic. No. That's not a good word, is it? Okay, and now I'm gonna contour my nose. To be honest, I don't know what this kind of brush is called. I'll just take a brush that looks like this. Again, I'm gonna take the lighter shade and put it on the side of my nose. And then I'm gonna take the darker shade as well to add a little bit here and here, because you want to make your lips look like, you know. And then I'm gonna take a blush. The one that I'm using right now is the Maybelline Fit Me blush in the shade Rose Claire. And then you're gonna take a blush brush. The one that I use, I got it for free from Ulta. Just gonna put this on my cheeks. And a little bit on my nose as well, because why not? But now I'm gonna do my brows. I think doing your brows is very important because your brows basically frame your entire face. And sometimes if I don't wear any makeup, I just do my brows and put on some lipstick.
So I'm gonna firstly draw a line underneath. Your brows basically end here. See that? So for me, I like to make my brows a little bit darker at the end. I can't really see clearly, so you know, just bear with me. By the way, I use brow powder from It's Cosmetics. Yep, and then I'm gonna take the other end, which is like a brush. I'm gonna brush through my brows to make it look more natural.
They are not really symmetrical, but that's fine because your brows are sisters, not twins. So I'm gonna take this brush. It's the e.l.f. C brush. And then just take any warm brown shade, like this one, and put it on your eyelid. This is actually a free sample I got from Ulta Beauty. After you put on this warm kind of shade, you want to take a darker shade. I'm just gonna use this one here. It's called Plum Drop. And then I'm gonna put it in my crease. And now I'm gonna curl my eyelashes. The one that I use is from Muji. I'm just gonna curl my eyelashes. Now I'm gonna take an eyeliner. I don't wanna put too much on either, so I'm just gonna put it at the end of my eyes, kinda like this. See that? You can put some in your tight lines as well. Now I'm gonna put on some highlighter. This is Smirking Whistles, Super Shark Cheek by ColourPop.
So just a little bit on my cheekbones. On my brow bones as well. And a bit on the bridge of my nose and to the right.
It's not really the fine. Oh wait! I forgot to put on mascara. Oh my god. The mascara that I really like right now is Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. Ah! And make sure that your eyelashes don't stick together. Excuse me, I ate too much. Now I'm gonna put on the lipstick. Usually for summertime, I like to use my favorite. Oh! Make sure your mascara is dry before you dramatically blink your eyes. During summertime, my favorite liquid lipstick is this one, Meet Matte Hughes, in the shade Committed by Da Bomb. But since it's winter time, I want to put on something that is more moisturizing. So I'm going to take this one. It's the YSL lipstick in the shade 12. Yeah, but I know that this can be very expensive for a lot of people. So just take any moisturizing lip balm or any moisturizing lipstick that you like. The last thing that I like to do is put a little bit of setting spray.
This one is from Milani. It's called Make It Last. You can skip this step if you don't have a setting spray.
Okay, so that is the makeup look.
Have a winning streak, baby. Rocket shit you can't pull off. Black Chelsea Bulls, son. Win, Louis Vuitton. You clipping cool points. Think it's a cool.